It's a typical Friday evening here in Charlotte, North Carolina. People have just gotten off work, traffic is heavy, and people are anxious to begin their weekend. While they're on their way home, listening to music, or talking on their cell phones, this young lady is walking up to her school. Not the school she attends, but the school she plans to open.
Hi, my name is Janicia Newsom, and I'm the founder and director of Upper Rail Leadership Academy.
Meet Janicia Newsom, a military veteran, a sister to two boys, one 13 and the other 17, and also director and founder of Uproar Leadership Academy. Take a listen as she walks us through where the idea of opening up her own school came from.
So really it all started back from when I was deployed in 2009, 2010, and I was having a conversation with my mother, and she told me that my youngest brother was diagnosed with dyslexia. And when she told me the amount of what it would cost per hour to provide tutoring for him, I felt like there was something that our community needed to give back to our children and provide them with the tools that they needed to be successful in school without it costing our parents. So I wrote my business plan for my nonprofit New Way Foundation, which offers free tutoring and mentoring to children in the Charlotte area. And I gave it to Ms. Purvis, who's my head of school, and she tells everybody it was 150 pages. But I really don't know, but she went through it, did the edits for me, and when we came home, I started the nonprofit. We received the 501c3 status, worked with kids in high school, those that were getting ready to drop out of high school, those that were using drugs, and we did the mentoring program. We put in sports just to give them something to look forward to, but also for us to be able to use as leverage. Of course, for kids, they need a motivation. So we did that to where we had some kids that received a scholarship for sports. We also have those that were not on track to graduate. They actually graduated. So imagine, you know, a parent calling you and they're crying tears of joy saying, "My baby finally made it." You know, that right there alone was payment for us.
It is one thing to have a dream, but quite another to fulfill it. And Ms. Newsom did not hesitate. She was not afraid to get her hands dirty, nor did she hesitate to enlist the help of others. We asked Ms. Newsom, what inspires you? Better yet, who exactly inspires you?
So the person that inspires me is my younger self. Knowing what I went through as a child and some adversities that I was faced with, not, you know, being in a certain sector of my life to where I was told that I couldn't make it, you know, those that were my instructors and telling me that I wouldn't amount to what society wants me to be. That's what inspires me, because that's not true. I'm in a totally different place in my life right now, and I want to pass on that same message to our students that you're able to make it in your life. You just have to have that drive and dedication, and those that are in your corner that wants to help you, receive that help, but you have to be willing to help yourself for others to be able to help you.
We couldn't leave the interview without asking Ms. Newsom one more question. What message do you have to give to the kids?
So the main point I would tell a young person is to be consistent, you know, have that drive, have that dedication. Remember, it's you against the world, like you're all you've got. So at the end, you may have others that doubt you or say that you can't make it, but just knowing that you believe in yourself, that should be good enough for you to continue on doing what you need to do to be successful in life.